Hey guys, so I'm going to try a little bit of a voiceover on my video here today. I've never done a voiceover before, so I hope this turns out okay. Anyway, here I am pushing back the cuticles on her nail plate gently with a cuticle pusher. So now I'm going to remove the gel from her nails. This glitter is embedded, so it takes a little bit more to get all the gel taken down. Now I'm just going to pre-shape her nail with a hand file, as well as I'm going to be removing some of the shine on the natural nail as well as the enhancement. Sometimes I do use a zebra sanding band to remove some of the shine on the nail, but this time I'm just going to be using a hand file. Here I'm just taking my Erica Skyver bit that I got from the pink chair to gently remove the cuticle on the nail plate. After I've completed going in one direction, I do put the e-file in reverse and I go back over all five nails and go along the other side of the nail. Applying a sticky primer. It is power based by Elite Beauty Supplies and it dries to a very sticky finish. So for this client, I do use Light Elegance. I am sticking on Tack, which is Light Elegance's bonder, and that's going to cure in the lamp. after the base has been cured. I'm just coming in here with natural fiber gel from Light Elegance. Nice thin layer, just as a nice protection layer before applying color glitter. I do like to embed my gel, so I do like to put a nice protection layer on the nails so that come fill time, I don't overfile her nails. After the fiber gel has cured in the lamp, I am now just going in with just a thin layer of clear as I'm going to be adding some glitter. This thin layer of clear will be uncured, and then I'm just going to press the glitter right into that sticky layer and then cure in the lamp. Pinky, pointer, and thumbs are going to get a gel paint on them. So I'm going to build out the nail and then I'm going to file them to shape before adding the gel paint. So the gel has cured in the lamp, so now I'm just going to file, buff, and shape the nails. pointer finger likes to grow downward, so I had to do a rebalance on it, which included adding a little bit more gel on the tip of the nail to bring that nail right back up. So it took me a little extra longer to file the nail. My trick to getting the perfect length on every nail. I don't really like to bend the client's fingernails to check the length because sometimes the clients just don't bend that way. So my little trick is to grab a little sewing tape measure and I just measure it up. The nails have been filed, buffed, and shaped. I'm just going to remove the dust with the brush. So after removing the dust from the nail, I just take a cuticle pusher and get in there and try and remove any other dust that is stuck in between the nail enhancement as well as the proximal nail fold. This helps give the gel polish a really clean, smooth surface to glide on, because sometimes when you're butting up that gel polish right up to that proximal nail fold, that the gel will grab that dust, and that's when you start to get those little bumps and gunk in your gel. So just before adding the color gel, I do like to take that cuticle pusher and give that skin one more quick push. That lets you get that brush super close in there and gives you a nice, clean, smooth line. So here I'm taking Max's from eContour Nails. I'm taking his Gold Precious Minerals Magnetic Top Coat to give a nice cat eye finish. So I had to give it a try on one of the sparkle nails as well. For the other sparkle nail, I'm just going to use Max's regular shiny top coat. Here's the finished look. Thank you for watching.